When it's cold out, your running gear will depend on a number of different factors, not the least of which is just how cold it is wherever you live, but your height and weight will matter too, as will other genetic factors. But let's dive in a little deeper into the clothing you'll need to safely run once things get chilly. It's probably best to wear more than necessary for the first couple of times, especially as the days get colder. Number 1. Long-sleeved shirts you can easily layer. Your body temperature will likely change while you run, especially if you start in the morning before the sun comes up. Long-sleeved shirts are usually a good idea, but try wearing two thin versions instead of one that is thicker, so you can easily remove layers, wrap it around your waist, and keep running in comfort. Number 2. A pullover or jacket. A simple pullover may be easier to take off quickly and wrap around your waist, but if you think a jacket would be warmer for the beginning of your runs, I'd suggest choosing a thinner option. There are plenty of jackets made specifically for outdoor runners that you can buy for around $100. These jackets are water and wind resistant and great at locking in body heat without being bulky. Number 3. Running leggings. When the temperature starts to cool, shorts may eventually be an unrealistic option for your outdoor exercise. Instead, you should probably try a pair of running leggings. You can even double up if you want to take the layered approach. Though, you may get some strange looks if you begin taking your pants off. Many outdoor runners choose to wear a tight pair of running shorts over a pair of leggings, as this seems to offer the perfect combination of warmth and mobility. Number 4. Winter running shoes. If you won't be battling snow and ice, your current pair of running shoes may work just fine. Now might be a good time to check the treads on them. If they're worn down, you may want to replace them. On the other hand, if you could use a little extra stability, then consider the benefits of wearing winter running shoes. Typically, these shoes come with greater traction, added water resistance, and even more room if you wish to wear an extra pair of socks. Or you could opt for slip-on cleats. Like the Yak Trax Run Traction cleats, which are only about $20. Number 5. A winter hat. You may have heard that we lose about half of our body heat through our heads. That's actually not true. It's probably closer to 7 to 10%. And yet, I'd still recommend that you wear a winter hat when running. It'll keep you warm, and it's also an easy way to protect your ears from the low temperatures. There are minimalist earmuffs that are perfect for runners. It might seem like a small thing, but consider how far away your ears are from your heart. More effort is required for your heart to move blood there and warm them up, especially when you have large muscles competing for it. You can also pair earmuffs with a running hat for help keeping hair and sweat out of your face without having to wear the more traditional winter option. Number 6. Gloves and socks. Similar to your ears, your fingers and toes can easily go cold if you don't give them a little extra help because of their location. So remember to wear gloves and don't skimp on the socks. Double them up if necessary. As far as gloves go, there are options made specifically for runners, but don't feel too much pressure if your budget is a concern. The main thing is that you have gloves that retain body heat. The same goes for socks. Number 7. Polarized sunglasses with UV protection. Yes, this is a bit of a shameless plug. Hear me out though. If you're going to be running when the sun is up and you're surrounded by snow, your eyes are going to get absolutely pummeled by UV rays. They'll bounce right off the reflective surface of the snow and hit your eyes from every angle. Sunglasses with UV 400 protection will keep your peepers safe, so outdoor runs don't become a problem for them. Polarized lenses will also make it easier to see where you're going. Running outside in cold weather is easy. While some minor adjustments to your gait and preparations are necessary, and you may need to update your wardrobe a bit, you can absolutely run outside when the weather gets colder.